everyone, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today I'm going to be starting seeds for summer. Now, if you look outside right now, it is not very summery. It's in the 30s, and it's foggy, and it's cold out.
And you were just in the greenhouse.
Yesterday it was 60, so we've changed for now. But what I'm going to do today is start some of the most tender of the things that will be in our garden, and those would be the tomatoes and the peppers. I also have a couple of, one butterfly bush grouping that I want to plant because that's going to get a little bit bigger. I think it needs a little bit longer to get started. What I'm using is called a biodome, and we tried these last year, and we were very pleased with them. It's like a little greenhouse that you can open and close for venting. Once you get everything planted, you really don't need to do anything except make sure that there's enough water in the bottom. And what you do is you use these little sponge plugs that comes with the dome, and that wicks the water up to where the hole is where you've put the seeds. Okay, so these go in here, you push them down, and then you put your seed in there, and it'll wick right up. Well, last year when we did this, we got carried away. Of course we did. We always do. And we filled a big one up, one that's twice as big, and this one, and we planted everything, including squash and sunflowers and all sorts of things that got way too big. I was rereading the instructions for this the other day, and it said, once your plants get their real leaves, so first come the two little leaves and then come the real leaves, once they get those, you take these out of here, the little sponge part, and you put it in its own little pot or a bigger area.
You don't
let them stay in here like we did. Live and learn. We're experimental, eclectic gardens. So what I'm going to do today when we get out to the back porch is what I'm doing is I'm going to skip each hole so that there is a little bit more room. So if they do get a little bit bigger, that's okay. And then they'd be easier to get out as well. You need to mark what you're planting so you know what you've planted. And thank you, Pepper. We don't need your help. What I'm using is a vinyl shade slat. You know how when you, well, with those you can't see, but window shades, sometimes they get old. Instead of throwing them all away, take some out, save them in their long form, and then you can always cut them up and make your own plant markers. I'm using, and I've learned from the past that if you put a nice sharp edge on them, they're easier to get in the soil or in here, and then use a Sharpie that has a very fine point on it because it's really hard to write with a very large one. You can't get all your words on there. So I'm going to take these out. Now, today I'm going to be planting the Peach Blow Sutton tomato that we just loved last year. That's this one. It has a fuzzy skin on it. It's not awful fuzzy like a peach, because I don't like that, but it's different. It's not a smooth skin like most tomatoes. Very tasty, very nice. We like them that they were different.
Is that the one that you cut in the middle and has that marbling that it goes?
No. That is the pineapple tomato.
Oh, that's right.
Yes, yep. And that one, I think we loved it even more just for the beauty of it, even more than the taste of it, although the taste was great and it was a very large tomato.
It's like an abstract painting inside.
It was. They were beautiful. Okay, and then Sue and Steve gave us what was called a Pomodoro. Oh, help me, Rick.
Bondo Lascaro.
It's an Italian tomato. And we think it's a cherry tomato, but a big cherry tomato. we're going to find out. It was hard to even find information about it on the internet. And then it was all in Italian, so we had to use Google Translate, of course. Phyllis has sent me many seeds to start, and she thought we might like ghost pepper because our son-in-law and our son, thank you, Pepper, like hot food, spicy food. Ghost peppers are known for that. And then I'm starting butterfly bush, which I believe does actually turn into a bush. We're going to find that out.
It's a different variety than the ones we currently have.
Yes, these are not the butterfly milkweed. These are butterfly bush.
Okay.
So we'll see.
Yep.
So I'm going to start these five different things. And
you mean you're not going to start all of these
today? I'm not starting all of these today, and especially not
Why
things
not?
Like cucumbers that you can put right into the ground, and zucchini into the ground, radishes. These I may be getting started shortly. These are flowers. These are coleus again. We had a lot of fun last year with our coleus. And then these are zinnias, a variety of zinnias, and a bunch of things, but they don't need to be going out there right now. We're out here on our chilly back porch. It's probably about 10 degrees warmer than what would be outside, and inside the greenhouse it was in the 70s, and that was after I had not had the heating pads on for a while and the lights on. What you see around us is a lot of things that have been stored for winter. All right, now I put all of my little sponge plugs in. I skipped a space in between, like I said I was going to, and then I'm going to mark each row depending on what I'm planting. So this whole row is going to be Peach Blow Sutton. All right, and now I'm going to take these tiny little tomato seeds, which are not the tiniest seeds I'm going to be planting today, and the easiest way to get them out is to wet a
toothpick,
right? And I'm going to pick up one or two, maybe one, and then just put it, and because they're so tiny, I'm not even going to drop them down into the hole at this point. I'm just setting them on top. And I think I'll put at least two or three on each one. I can always take out plants I don't want or transplant them someplace else into another pot. Oops, that one went way down. Come on. Yes, and now you're going to get in the wrong row and get me all mixed up.
Well, maybe you should do one at a time.
Well, they kind of are sticking.
I know. You could become a dentist.
Yeah, I feel like a dentist. Here we go. Get on there. Oops. That one's flying all over the place. They're alive. It's a good thing that they're watered from the bottom, because otherwise you'd knock them right off and lose them for sure.
So the whole thing wicks upward.
Correct. Okay, now I got my system in order here. Now, if all of these seeds germinate and turn into plants, that's a lot of Peach Blow Sutton plants, but that's okay.
Yes.
Because I'm sure they're not all going to work. Now, the next row is going to be the pineapple tomato seeds. These I saved from the ones we grew. So these are a little bit bigger. If I could use a tweezer, it would be nice. Oops, but they're kind of stuck together from being tomatoes. So I'm just going to set that little bunch there, and then I will take them apart after I get them out. Let's get enough for two. these over here.
You missed one.
Well, I'm going to take some from here. Oh. Put over here.
Oh, okay.
As long as they jumped out, they wanted to go on their own. All right. Again, as they start to germinate, I can take them and put them in another pod. Space them out a little bit more.
Or just simply thin them.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. You can take these over here. Okay.
Okay.
Next I'm doing the Pomodoro. And these, again, are a little bit larger. So I think this time I'm just going to put them in my hand. There we go. And then I can just set them. Again, I'm setting them on top because they're small seeds. Now, like a bean seed, if you're going to try a bean, I don't recommend it because they grow too fast. But you'd put it right down in the hole. Last year we did some sunflowers and we stuck those right in the pre-made hole.
In other words, each of these little sponges come with a hole smack dab in the center.
Correct. Okay, ghost peppers next. I'm going to put this right here right away so I don't forget. And these, again, are larger seeds, so I'm just going to dump some in my hand. Woo!
Just don't rub your eyes.
No. Definitely not. I might even put a couple down inside there. I don't know. Well, since these are the only pepper plants in here, we'll know what they are. If they start coming up from where I dropped a few in the bottom.
Yes, table.
They're jumping out everywhere. Come on. Now these are going to be a real treat because that's how big they are. They're like dust.
Somehow I don't think I'll even be able to see what you're doing.
Well, again, I'm going to try putting them in my hand. They are really tiny.
My goodness. Yep, I see them.
Mm-hmm. And maybe this is time to do the water and the toothpick thing again. All right, I'm just going to wipe it on the top, I guess. Yep, that worked.
Imagine going out there and trying to find them and harvest them?
No, I have no idea how people do this.
I mean, just remember coleus seeds?
Yes, those were larger than these. I think I have a few more in here. And I might as well use them all up because... I can't even see if they're out of there. Okay, we're going to say those are done. Now, can you imagine if I just started sprinkling this and all the seeds would go everywhere, which is what you don't have to do because of the biodome. You just pour the water in the bottom and you fill it up about between a quarter and a half an inch.
Actually, when that thing starts to float, right?
Yep.
Then you know you have enough water in
mm-hmm.
there.
Mm-hmm. And then
it's
every day,
indicator.
It's my job to make sure that there's enough water in the bottom.
Yep,
here we go.
It starts to float.
Okay, so now we know you are all set. I'm going to take this, put it on the top.
Over more.
Thank you.
And what's nice about this, too, is it has these little adjustable vents so that
yes.
you can close them.
Yes, and for right
and,
now,
yeah.
I'm closing. then I'm going over here where the greenhouse is.
I'm going to rebuild this next year. Actually, nice, maybe later.
Nice and warm. I could jump in there. Since this is the only thing in here, I can put this lamp down kind of in the middle. I'll have to adjust the cord there. Now let me just adjust this cord so it can get over where it belongs. There we go. Now I already have the lights set as on a timer, so they'll go off at 7 o'clock tonight. They'll come back on 7 in the morning. I'll pull this down again so it stays toasty in here.
And that's just a good heavy sheet of plastic that I found that helps keep the moisture inside.
Mm-hmm. And while it isn't airtight, which you don't want, it allows enough breezes to come in here so the plants won't overheat. The pads themselves are set for the proper temperature. And as the plants grow and we move them into different pots, I'll also add a fan that I'll have going to keep the air circulating and to strengthen the little plants so that when they get out in the world,
the real world,
they'll be strong enough to stand up to the wind. So we hope you enjoyed this beginning of our growing season. It's very exciting. If you did, please give us a thumbs up. We'd appreciate that. And if you have comments or questions, please leave us a little note on our page. Also, if you'd like to become part of our garden family, remember there's that little tiny little button over here somewhere, and you can subscribe to our channel. We'd appreciate that too. Bye for now. Stay safe. Stay healthy.
Connect with us on YouTube.